Dear students, I am Mary A. Jalil, Assistant Professor, Department of Tripoli, Arunachala College of Engineering for Women. In this video lecture, we are going to see Introduction to Control Systems. The topics to be covered in this presentation are What is a system? What is a control system? Next, we will see its types. Last, we will see few examples of control system. What is a system? When a number of elements or components are connected in a sequence to perform a specific function, the group thus formed is called a system. What is control system? In a system, when the output quantity is controlled by varying the input quantity, the system is called control system. In other words, control system can be defined as an interconnection of components forming a system configuration that will provide a desired system response. The output quantity is called controlled variable or response. The input quantity is called command signal or excitation. There are two types of control system. First one is open loop system and the next one is closed loop system. What is open loop control system? Any physical system which does not automatically correct the variation in its output is called open loop system. It is also called non-feedback system. This is the simpler one. Here, the output quantity has no effect upon the input quantity. This means the output is not fed back to the input for correction. This is the basic block diagram of an open loop control system. It has two components. First one is a controller and the second one is the plant or process. Here, an input is applied to a controller and it produces an actuating signal or controlling signal. This signal is given as an input to a plant or process which is to be controlled. So, the plant produces an output which is controlled. So, the output is not fed back to the input in an open loop system. So, the control action is independent of the desired output. What are the advantages of open loop system? Open loop systems are very simple. Economical, it is easier to construct, it is generally stable. What are the disadvantages of open loop system? It is inaccurate and unreliable. Changes in the output due to external disturbance are not corrected automatically. Now we will see few examples of open loop control system. Automatic washing machine, electric bulb, electric hand dryer, time-based bread toaster, volume of the audio system, water faucet, TV remote control, clothes dryer. What is a closed loop control system? The control system in which the output has an effect upon the input quantity so as to maintain the desired output values are called closed loop control system. By adding the feedback path element, we can convert the closed loop system to, open loop system to closed loop system. This is the basic block diagram of automatic control system. It has four components. First one is an error detector. Second one is a controller. Third one is the system or plant. Last one is the feedback path element or feedback element. This feedback signal is obtained from the block, that is the feedback path element block, by considering the output of the overall system as an input to this block. Instead of the direct input, the error signal is applied as an input to a controller. The feedback path element samples the output and it converts to a signal of same type as that of the reference signal. Feedback signal is proportional to the output signal and is fed back to the error detector. This error detector produces an error signal, which is the difference between the input and the feedback signal. The controller modifies and amplifies the error signal to produce better control action. In other words, the controller produces an actuating signal which controls the plant. Here, the output of the control system is adjusted automatically. Hence, this closed loop system is also called automatic control system. We have seen traffic control system. If in a traffic control system, if it has sensors attached to it, it is an example of closed loop control system. What are the advantages of closed loop control system? It is accurate. It is accurate even in the presence of non-linearities. It is less affected by noise. Sensitivity of the system may be made small to make the system more stable. What are the disadvantages of closed loop system? It is complex and costly. Feedback in closed loop system may lead to oscillatory response. Feedback reduces the overall gain of the system. Stability is the main problem, so more care should be needed to design a stable closed loop system. Now we will see few examples of open and closed loop control system. The first example we are considering is a temperature control system. Now we will see how this temperature control system is operating under open loop mode. So here we are taking an electric furnace as a temperature control system. In this block diagram, we have a relay control unit. You have an electric furnace in which a heating element is placed, a sensor, an A2D converter, an interface, and a digital display are the components present in the system. The output in the system is the desired temperature. The temperature of the system is raised by heat generated by the heating element. The output temperature depends on the time during which the supply to heater remains on. The on and off of the supply is governed by the time setting of the relay. The temperature is measured by a sensor which gives an analog voltage corresponding to the temperature of the furnace. The analog signal is converted to digital signal by an A2D converter. The digital signal is given to the digital display device to display the temperature. In this, if there is any change in output temperature, then the time setting of the relay is not altered automatically. Now we will see how this temperature control system is converted into closed loop control system. We can convert the open loop system to closed loop system by just adding a feedback path element. In this electric furnace circuit diagram, we have an amplifier and a DA converter in the feedback path. So this is made as a closed loop system. The output of the closed loop system is the desired temperature, and it depends on the time during which the supply to heater remains on. The switching on and off of the relay is controlled by a controller, which is a digital computer or digital system. The desired temperature is input to the system through the keyboard or as a signal corresponding to the desired temperature via ports. The actual temperature is sensed by sensor and it is converted to digital signal by analog to digital converter. The computer reads the actual temperature and compares with the desired temperature. If it finds any difference, then it sends the signal to switch on and on or off the relay through DA converter and amplifier. Thus, the system automatically corrects any changes in output. Hence, it is a closed loop system. The second example we are going to see is a traffic control system. How this traffic control system is working in open loop system, that we will see first. The traffic control by means of traffic signals operated on a time basis constitutes an open loop control system. The sequence of control signals are based on a time slot given for each signal. The time slots are decided based on a traffic study. The system will not measure the density of the traffic before giving the signals. Since the time slot does not change according to traffic density, the system is an open loop system. Now we will see how this traffic control system acts under closed loop system. The traffic control system can be made as a closed loop system if the time slots of the signals are decided based on the density of traffic. In closed loop traffic control system, the density of the traffic is measured on all the sites and the information is fed to a computer. The timings of the control signals are decided by the computer based on the density of traffic. Since the closed loop system dynamically changes the timings, the flow of vehicles will be better than open loop system. The third example we are going to see is a numerical control system. So in a numerical control system, first one we will see how it is working under open loop system. In a numerical control system, we have a magnetic disk, reader, DTA converter, amplifier, servo motor, a cutter and a machine tool. The numerical control is a method of controlling the motion of machine components using of numbers. Here, the position of work head tool is controlled by the binary information contained in a disk. A magnetic disk is prepared in binary form representing the desired path P. Here P is a metal part to be machined. The tool will operate on the desired part P. To start the open loop system, the disk is fed through the reader to the D2A converter. So the D2A converter converts the frequency modulated output of the reader to analog signal. It is then amplified and fed to a servo motor which positions the cutter on the desired part P. The position of the cutter head is controlled by the angular motion of the servo motor. This is an open loop system since no feedback path exists between the output and input. The system positions the tool for a given input command. Any deviation in the desired position is not checked and corrected automatically. Now, we are converting this numerical control system, that is the open loop system, into closed loop system by adding a feedback path element. This feedback path element is nothing but an A to D converter. Here, a magnetic disk is prepared in binary form representing the desired path P. To start the closed loop system, the disk is loaded in the reader. The controller compares the frequency modulated input pulse signal with the feedback pulse signal. The controller is a computer or microprocessor system. It carries out mathematical operations on the difference in the pulse signals and generates an error signal. The D2A converter converts the controller output pulse or error signal into an analog signal. The amplified analog signal rotates the servo motor to position the tool on the job. The position of the cutter head is controlled according to the input of the servo motor. The transducer attached to the cutter head converts the motion into an electric signal. The analog electric signal is converted to the digital pulse signal by the A to D converter. Then this signal is compared with the input pulse signal. If there is any difference between these two, the controller sends a signal to the servo motor to reduce it. Thus, the closed loop system automatically corrects any deviation in the desired output tool position. An advantage of numerical control is that complex parts can be produced with uniform tolerances at the maximum milling speed. The fourth example we are going to see is a position control system using servo motor. This is a closed loop system. Here we have an input potentiometer, an amplifier, you have a generator and a motor set, you have a gear and load arrangement, and then feedback potentiometer. The system consists of a servo motor powered by a generator. The load whose position has to be controlled is connected to a motor shaft through gear wheels. Potentiometers are used to convert the mechanical motion to electrical signals. The desired load position is set on the input potentiometer, and the actual position is fed back to the feedback potentiometer. The difference between the two angular positions generates an error signal, which is amplified and then fed to generator field circuit. The induced EMF of the generator drives the motor. The rotation of the motor stops when the error signal is zero, that is, when the desired load position is reached. This type of control systems are called servo mechanisms. The servo or servo mechanisms are feedback control systems in which the output is the mechanical position or time derivatives of position, example, velocity, acceleration. So, in this video, we have seen what is system, what is control system, what are the two basic types of control system, and we have seen few examples of control systems. Thank you.